Once again, it's the next four morning, 1960, coming riding just about to start. Tillingman is in the Westport, preparing to read the barley, cry the barley for the first time in 1960, on a beautiful summer evening. Very, very dull and unsettled all day, but a beautiful evening as you look right up the valley to the hills of Yarrow. Food barns now coming up the back row toward the coin, where the barley will be cried once again tonight.
Notice the provost, magistrates and councillors of the Royal Borough of Selkirk have been fixed tomorrow, Friday, the 17th day of June, 1960, for the raiding of the marches of the town's land. Hereby summon the neighbor inheritors and all others to attend for their interest. They have appointed the following as burnermen to be round the marches of the said Royal Borough's property and land. Thomas Kellett, at the Clark Cottages. Frank McCudden, Cow Street. George Mitchell, Rayburn Meadow. Bart Wilson, the first. The Pomeroy, a standard bearer. Robert M. Brenton, out home. And the Pomeroy has attended Elliot Grieve, Grieve House. Thomas Brian Kerr, Bow Street. Austin Lindors, Thornfield Avenue, and Ian McCadden, South Street. There will be all these and a great many more, and all to make ready to start at the sound of the second drum.
Still with the flute band coming back from Mungo Park morning along the highway towards the marketplace. Very near now to 6 o'clock. Clock chapping in the old tune clock. Soon the band will be along now. Hail smelling on. What a lovely sunny morning as the band comes along towards the marketplace. Great crowd in the square waiting on them coming along. Thank you. now to the county hotel where I'm speaking now and walk in at the county hotel. What a great crowd to see there. What a sight. Young and old, all ages in the march.